Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to scare you.
Holy cow.
Hi, I'm Mark Williams. I live down the street.
I'm Miranda Sterling.
Are you sure you're all right?
Yeah, no worries.
Okay, by the way, this is for you.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Just a little something to welcome you into the neighborhood.
Well, you said you live down the street?
Yes, just down the cul-de-sac.
Oh, okay. I just thought...
You thought what?
Oh, nothing.
Oh, very well. Have a pleasant day.
Oh, well, would you like to stay for a drink, maybe?
Well,
I drove like 8 hours from Florida, and I haven't had any company.
Well, yeah, I can stay for a few minutes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
So tell me, why did you move here to South Carolina?
Well, back in Florida, I was going through some tough times.
Oh?
Yeah. A few years back, my sister Janet died in a car crash. It was really hard on my parents. High school was the worst for me. Until my senior year when I met Willard. After graduation, we moved in together and he worked full time and I was in college studying graphic design. We were gonna get married, but I couldn't find a job anywhere in Florida, but I found one here. He refused to move here with me, so I came by myself.
Sorry you had to go through all that.
Well, the way I see it is just getting a fresh start in my new life.
When do you start your new job?
Monday. So what about you? Did you move here from anywhere?
Actually, I was born and raised here in Greenville, South Carolina. I'm a psychiatrist.
Oh, so you're a doctor?
Yes.
Is that any fun?
Sometimes it is, and sometimes it's not. Sometimes it can be very difficult. Anyway, I hate to cut it short, but it's about time that I head back up to the office. I've got to get some paperwork done. But before I go, I have a card here for you. And it's got my phone number, it's got my email and my address on there. Not that you need my address, because I live just down the street. But if you need me, just let me know. You can call me or ring my doorbell.
Thank you, Doctor.
Please, call me Mark. Hi.
Hello.
Are you the new neighbor?
Yes, I am.
I'm Stuart Sullivan. I lived across the street from you.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
This is for you.
Oh, thank you.
Where are you from?
Destin, Florida.
Are you married?
No.
Do you have any kids?
No.
Do you have a boyfriend?
That's none of your business.
Did you break up with anyone?
Like I said, that's none of your concern.
I got a wife.
Okay. Well, that's nice. Listen, I got some work I gotta get done. We can talk later, okay? Bye.
Election day last year. Were you on for that trial? Were you on for that election?
Mark, it's Miranda. I think someone's trying to break into my house.
Miranda.
Ah! Oh my god, oh my god, Mark! I am so sorry. Are you alright? Oh my god. Sorry about your
I'm
head.
Okay.
So sorry.
Oh, I'm fine.
Here.
Oh, thank you.
Mark, I cannot tell you how sorry I am. I feel like such an idiot.
It's okay, Miranda. I can tell you were scared.
I mean, I got you out of bed, and...
Well, actually, I wasn't in bed.
You weren't?
No, I was up on my computer doing some work stuff.
Is your head okay?
It's fine, thank you.
Hey, do you know Stuart?
Stuart Sullivan? Mm-hmm. Like, across the street?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, is he okay?
What do you mean, is he okay?
Like, is he all there? He asked me a few personal questions.
Oh, okay. This happened about a year ago. Stuart had a wife named Ellie, and they were so in love with each other. They did everything together. They went to the movies, they went on vacation, they went downtown all the time. And they were great. Stuart was the brightest man I've ever known.
You guys must have been really good friends.
We were. I was especially with Ellie, too. She happened to be my sister.
Oh, okay.
So, about a year ago, Ellie got sick. When she was ill, she got a little bossy around Stuart, and he took it personally. And they started to fight, and fight, and fight, all the time, about heaven knows what. And one day, Stuart came home, and he found Ellie dead in their basement. She sliced her throat open. So, ever since then, Stuart hasn't been the same. And who could blame him? He's been in that house for a year now by himself, and he just hasn't taken it well at all.
I feel terrible now. He came to my house the other day, and he brought me this card, and I haven't even opened it yet, but he kept asking me these personal questions, and I didn't want to answer them.
I understand. Stuart's been my patient for a while now, and he still is. I talk to him about once a week, and he's not used to Ellie being gone yet. So, in turn, he's not really good with new girls, talking to new girls. So, I guess I'm hoping, and I'm guessing that once he comes to terms with the fact that she's in a better place, then he'll start to be himself again. And he won't have that problem.
Ellie was your sister. You must have taken it really hard. I mean, are you okay?
Well, I'll be honest. At first, I wasn't okay. I took it pretty hard. But now that I think about it, I realize that she's in a better place. And that I'll get to see her again. One day, soon.
Need a hand?
Oh, sure, yeah. Actually, could you grab the eggs from the trunk? Thank you. Thank you.
Look, about yesterday, I didn't mean to upset you with all the money. I asked you all these questions.
You didn't upset me. I don't feel comfortable sharing information with people I don't know.
Well, let me make it up to you tonight. If you want, you can join me at my place for dinner.
Sounds great, but I actually have stuff I gotta get done, so.
Mark will be there. I heard you're really good friends with him.
Yeah, well, unfortunately, I actually do have stuff I have to do.
Hey, Stuart, what you doing?
I'm just walking down the neighborhood.
Great. Listen, have you seen Miranda today?
No, I haven't.
Weird. I think she's missing.
What makes you think that?
Well, I went over to her house, the door's cracked, and she's not home.
Huh.
I think something's wrong. Stuart?
Yeah?
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You sure you're not hiding anything?
Nope, I am not.
Okay, listen, can you do me a favor and just please look out for Miranda today?
Yeah, sure.
All right, I'll see you around, man. Thanks.
Yeah, see ya.
Thank you.
You alright? I'm gonna get you out of here, okay?
Mark, look behind me! Look behind me!
Why? After everything I've done for you?
No! You're just like everyone else!
What the hell are you doing?
Continuing the family tradition.
You killed your wife. She didn't commit suicide. You killed Ellie.
And now, they'll share the same.
I know, but we have to get out of here before the cops show up, okay? Come on. Let's go.